Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to discuss what is corresponding angles. Before that, we already know what is parallel lines. Parallel lines means when two lines that do not meet at any point are called parallel lines. Okay, let's see, line L and line M are parallel. Doesn't matter how much extend them. They do not meet each other. Such lines are parallel lines. Let's see, how do you denote parallel lines? So we can denote it as L parallel M. Let's see in the symbol. Okay, so let's see what is corresponding angles. When two parallel lines, line L and line M, are intersected by transversal P, so there are formed some different angles. So let's see angles. First, an angle phi U are called corresponding angles. So let's see angle first and angle 7 on the same side of transversal. It means, let's see in the figure, on the left side of transversal and at different vertices. So that we can define corresponding angles. It means pair of corresponding angles. When two parallel lines intersect by transversal, angles form at intersecting point so that angles are on same side of transversal and at different vertices are called pair of corresponding angles. Okay, in this way we can define pair of corresponding angles. So let's see in the figure, angle 2 and angle 6 are on the right side of the transversal and above the line L and M. So angle 2 and angle 6 are called pair of corresponding angles. So in this way, let's see, angle 3 and angle 7 are on the same side. It means left side of the transversal and below the line M and L. So this another pair of transversal. In this way, similarly, let's see, angle 4 and angle 8 are the pair of corresponding angles. So we can say there are four pair of corresponding angles formed when transversal intersect two parallel lines. And one more thing, let's see, if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, each pair of corresponding angles is equal in measure. I repeat, if two parallel lines are cut by transversal, each pair of corresponding angles is equal in measure. So that, let's see, pair of corresponding angles, angle 1 is equal to angle 5, angle 3 is equal to angle 7, angle 2 is equal to angle 6, angle 4 is equal to angle 8, in case of parallel lines. Okay. So let's see one example. Find x. Let's see in the figure, there are line L and line M are parallel lines and a transversal T. So we have to find x. It means angle x and angle 120 are in corresponding pairs because both are in same side, both are in left side of transversal and above the line L and M. So angle X and angle 120 are in corresponding pair. So we know angles are in corresponding pairs if in case of parallel lines. So we can say corresponding angles are in equal measure so that angle AX is equal to 120. Okay, because in case of parallel lines, corresponding angles are in equal measure. That's why measurement of angle X is 120. This is the way to find unknown angles by using corresponding pair. Let's see one more example. Find angle Z. In the figure, line L and M are parallel lines and having transversal T. So by using pair of corresponding, find the angle Z. This question for you, try it and commit the answer. Okay, thank you, and subscribe my YouTube channel.